Hey guys, this is Home Cell Defense with Tom and Bob again, and today I'm gonna do a little video about knife awareness. It's not gonna be knife techniques, it's not gonna be knife fights, it's not gonna be like to really defend yourself against the knife attacks, which is spiritually impossible, but I just want to tell you about the mental approach and the thing that you can do to not to get hypnotized with that blade, so you won't freeze, you won't get adrenal shock, and you maybe will be able to either clear or fight your opponent back. Okay guys, so let's talk awareness really. Okay, for most of people, the knife situation starts here with very stabbing, with pumping. Okay guys, but I'm really, if you are out there on the street or even at home, would I say someone that abuse you at home and trying to use any knife against you, of course the first thing that he has to do is reach for that knife. Okay, that knife could be in my pocket. Okay, the knife is now in my pocket. So if I will get with argument with Bobby here and we're gonna struggle and we're gonna push each other or going to constant, he has to reach into his pocket once he feels or try to overwhelm him. Okay, reach for that blade, open that blade, or pull it out somehow if that's a fixed blade. Okay, just grab it properly and try to stab me. All those operations takes time to perform. Okay, so being simply aware, not just looking around trying to find out if there is someone to help me. Just watch that motherfucker, guys. I mean, any situation, again, poop scenario, someone is approaching you and trying to stick his hand into the pocket. You never know what is gonna be. It could be his mobile phone, it could be few quid, but then that could be a knife that's gonna get stuck into your goods. Okay, so listen guys, Bobby here today has a knife as well. Okay, so look, Bobby has it fixed to his hand. Wouldn't say if Bobby has it in his pocket just right here. Okay, and he's approaching me. Guys, honestly, I do it many times. Even on the street, happened to me a few times out there as well. So if he's reaching to his pocket, you just lock. Listen guys, I mean you lock his hand there, okay? If you don't want to go into straight line, you just lock his hand just there, okay? The other hand goes up, the other hand goes up, and then you can easily ask, sorry buddy, what are you doing, what's your intentions here, okay? Now, he might go a little bit mad. Okay, so if his intentions were clear, he's gonna go bananas, he's gonna go all scared. But guys, you can really explain yourself. Okay, you can say the knife crime is at its peak, and that's a simple awareness that saved your ass a couple of times already. Simple tactic of a lock in the hand with a simple intent of reaching something into that pocket. Okay, so what you only risk is the apologies, maybe a joke, maybe a smile, maybe he will go mad, but then believe me guys, he won't be thinking about attacking you, because his first attempt for reaching into the pocket, okay, was just seeing his hand, and this weapon is primed for any attack around his face. Okay guys, so it's just simple as that. You see someone approaching you, whatever the intent is, whatever the place is, watch those hands reaching into any of the pockets, because guys, no one is carrying a knife just like that walking around town. Common sense, okay? So this knife is hidden somewhere. Okay, so again, let's have a look at situation that unfortunately happened in our community, okay? So listen guys, if there is a family of Josh around here, just advise them that maybe not to watch, because what I'm gonna explain here is how could happen that someone that went down to the ground, okay guys, went down to the ground, was able to reach into his pocket, get up, prime the weapon, stab someone three times, okay? With a bit of awareness, guys, when this fella goes down, okay, and start to reach into his pocket, you either clear your room like motherfucker, okay? Or grab whatever is there, grab your bikes and just kill the motherfucker. I mean just fucking kill him with the trash cans, kill him with fucking bottles. If there are still three of you, just fucking jump at him. Okay, because he's getting up, he's reaching into his pocket. If you don't want to kill him, move to secure him, check his hand, check his pockets for any weapon, then you can let him go to your mouth or let him to engage. He's hooked anyway, because there's a few of you. Okay? So, listen guys, even if one of you get in a scrap with someone and then the other spot a knife, make that a word. Shout, knife! Shout as fucking loud as you can, guys. Make other people aware of that knife. Okay? All eyes on him. Right? So, as we said, we are not showing how to deflect, all of those moves. Okay, guys? Because it's really something for completely different lesson. Okay? It's just that awareness of someone reaching into any, or the back. It could be reaching for the back. Something could be here. I had a situation with my neighbor, junkie neighbor here. The same story. Had a knife in the back. Had to take him away and clean out. Okay? So guys, your main concern really is here, with the awareness of a knife. Okay? It's not to get hypnotized with that shiny blade. I mean, look guys, there's that blade and it's fucking swinging and it's moving. Maybe it's just like that. But then believe me guys, what you're gonna do, you're gonna stare at that blade, focus on that blade, okay? Where the intent, it's still there, okay? So I'm not saying that you can't look at that knife, because you have to be aware of the knife. But don't get hypnotized. Don't get into any photo with that knife, because you're gonna lose. It's a simple pull and then cut, and you are fucked, okay? So first, what you're gonna do is, guys, really, if you can run any knife defense classes, first thing someone's showing the knife, literally you turn and you run like motherfucker. Maybe we'll be able to do that and get to safety. Okay guys, but sometimes running isn't really the option, okay? It's sometimes it's efficient, sometimes it just isn't, because you never know who's the better runner, and you're just panicking, and then you just get caught and stabbed into the back, okay? So, coming to that situation, what I would really do, I'd face my opponent if I can't really clean and escape. Would I face him properly? Hands up, okay? In my stance, ready to go. Full aggression on my face, okay? I mean, guys, now we want to really shrink his target a little bit. Protect all of your goods just here. Stand a little bit sideways and be ready just to blast with any attack that we show you on those beginner's course and other videos, okay? Because in the most cases, it's gonna be amateur, hopefully. Okay, so just by making yourself nice and tight and aggressive, guys, believe me, the knifer in the most situations, he don't want struggle, he don't want hassle, he want to use that knife as his advantage to gain something. If that's a fight situation, he of course want to reach for the blade because he was losing the fight and now he's just gonna play dirty. Okay, and then comes to simple awareness over him pulling the knife out of any pocket that he has, right? So listen guys, just by a simple fact of being ready to fight, being ready to face your opponent, being ready to get cut, okay? Instead of an adrenal shock that makes you freeze and you are unable to make any decision, there is no fight or flight anymore because you'll get paralyzed. Even for a couple of seconds, right? We all been there. Something's happened, we freeze, okay? So we don't want that, we don't want the shock, we want the boost. And the boost comes with awareness. Being code yellow all the time, knife situation, code red, engagement. Okay guys, I mean aggression, use that aggression, because if you won't use it, okay, that's the last time you see your families. Okay, so his gain is very, very little. His gain is money, maybe a harm. Our gain is major, it's our families, it's the people we love, it's our dreams, it's our means to provide for them. So any attack really, guys, on your good self, you have to treat as the attack on the whole of the people that are around you, that rely on you, the family mostly, okay? And you have to use as the advantage to build the aggression up, to spike that aggression to the point in which your opponent really start to be afraid of you, and then you become the attacker, okay? So never get hypnotized with the blade, okay? Be ready to fight. Be ready, you will get caught. But then be ready to overcome. Become the attacker. Eventually harm him and clear, okay? And now, guys, with the knife defense, in the most situation, the little tip is, with the palm strikes, you have the forearms open here, yeah? But then with the knife situation, you want to turn them a little, okay? So we have exposed those parts of the forearm when there is no veins. I mean, they still hurt from slashes, from cuts, but then sometimes the blade will get stuck in your jacket and it doesn't really hurt as much. Well, any contact close to the veins is gonna be a major problem, okay? And look, Bobby just in a sneaky way dropped his knife and nearly cut my foot, for which I'm gonna just pay nicely here. Okay guys, so knife awareness is a major thing. You know, one more practice with Bobby once happened that I had a knife attached for the upper attack. I pulled the string on hard and the knife literally from the impact slid from his hand and stabbed me right in the stomach and quite deeply, okay? So guys, I don't really advise you to practice with any real knives because that might end up with a disaster, okay? So guys, awareness, awareness, awareness. Outside, code yellow. Knife situation, code red. Be ready to clear, be ready to fight, be ready to kill, or be ready to escape. Okay, so that's our little video. The knife defense classes we're gonna do in the community center because they need a room, they need a people, okay? They need a proper explanation of any technique. And you can still fail, okay? So it's not like I'm gonna give you a tool that will 100% protect you from knife attack, because sometimes it just can't be done. Okay, so guys, I will see you on the next video. That's gonna be video again from our beginner's course, and we're gonna talk either a headlock or different chokes from different angles, this time with Preston. So I'm gonna throw him around again. Have a nice day, guys.